So definitely a lot to like here, and one huge benefit that no other VPN I've reviewed has offered. But Mysterium is still a young company, and there are some features missing that I really wish were there. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and I've tested numerous VPNs over the years, and frankly, they're all pretty much the same. A few different features here and there, of course, but a virtual private network is, for the most part, a one-trick pony. And that's why Mysterium caught my eye the first time I downloaded and opened the software. The biggest difference between this and a traditional VPN was huge, but I'll get into that in a moment. Let me step back and explain some things first. The reason I even downloaded Mysterium in the first place is because I've become intrigued with this idea of a decentralized VPN. I've explained this in more detail in the video linked to here, but the bottom line is this. Using a VPN is not a cloak of invisibility. It's merely a shift of your online trust away from your internet service provider, your government, your university, or some other entity, and into the hands of a VPN company. And this still exposes your privacy to some risk. Decentralization theoretically improves your privacy by putting your data into the hands of the worldwide community and not a single company or organization. And that's how Mysterium works. Similar to Tor, there's a network of nodes all over the globe. I run one here in Asia, and you could easily run one from your home as well, that essentially democratizes the internet and gives you the ability to earn a little extra money while you're at work or asleep. As I've used Mysterium this past month, I've come to understand the pros and cons of this kind of setup. First, as far as my privacy is concerned, I like knowing that the nodes on this network are not exclusively owned and operated by Mysterium or some data center, although I'm sure they do run some of them. From a practical standpoint, Mysterium allows me to stream Netflix and other such services, which Tor cannot do. I also love that Mysterium uses the new WireGuard encryption protocol, which is widely considered to be the fastest and most secure protocol today. On the other hand, I was only able to test this on my Mac and Android devices since they don't yet have an iOS version available, so that was a tad disappointing. Also, because we're dealing with nodes set up in homes and businesses, I've found that internet speeds vary wildly depending on the node I connect to. And since there's no smart selection or a current way to save nodes that I like, I find it hard to maintain consistent connection speeds with each new session. Representatives have shown me screenshots of how they're planning to fix this, so it's good to know that a solution is in the works. Finally, since Mysterium is run on a cryptocurrency called Mist, I found a lot of the numbers to be confusing. For example, you'll see here that I have a 6.8 Mist available in my account, and that connecting to this particular node would cost me 0.0001 Mist per minute and 0.1 Mist per gigabyte. I mean, it feels like I'm at the state fair where the introduction of a ticket currency makes me lose all sense of value, you know what I mean? But to translate this for you, at the time of this recording, I have about $1 worth of Mist available in my account. What does this really mean? Well, let's take Netflix for an example. Streaming a movie in HD usually requires about 90 minutes and 4.5 gigabytes of data. So to watch a full movie while connected to the Mysterium network would cost me about 6 cents, according to my math. Super cheap, right? I mean, a lot cheaper than your typical VPN service unless you're watching movies nonstop. It's hard to grasp that, though, when they display cryptocurrency in the software, and that's something else that they told me they're gonna fix. That's also what makes Mysterium so powerful when it comes to your online privacy. Remember what I said earlier about that huge difference between Mysterium and every other VPN I've reviewed? Well, watch as I open up the software and see if you can spot it. Did you see it? It's easy to miss if you're not looking for it. The glaring difference is that I never once had to sign up for an account using my email, my name, my credit card, or any other identifying info. I literally just downloaded the software, opened it up, and connected. Currently, it's all free, but I'm told that even when they launch, new users will receive a unique blockchain ID address. You then add credit via crypto payment method, and you're able to surf about as anonymously as is currently possible. Let me take you on a quick tour of the software here so you can see it for yourself. The Mysterium software looks very similar to what you'll find with any regular VPN service, with a list of countries on the left and the available servers or nodes on the right. You'll see with Mysterium that most of the nodes are located in the United States, the United Kingdom, and a number of them in Germany as well. But you can filter based on price limits, how much you're willing to pay, the quality of the node, how fast and how good a quality of the node do you want, and then the IP type. You can say that you only want nodes that are located in businesses or in hosting data centers or nodes that are located in residential places. So if I choose that and then I go into the United States, I can choose from any one of these nodes based on their price and the quality, and then I can connect to that node, and it'll take a few moments for it to connect, but once it does, on the bottom you're going to see that it lists the amount of time that I've been connected to the node, how much I've downloaded, how much I've uploaded, and then the price that I've paid in the MIST token in order to use that node and their available bandwidth. Up here, I can check how much available balance I have, as well as top up that balance, which, as I've explained, is a little bit confusing. And right now, I'll just go ahead and tell you, it's been very hard for me to find a way to top up that balance. There is another way to go about using the MIST network. It's something called the portals.network, and that adds another layer of payment on top where you can use your credit card or PayPal to pay for the service. It still uses the same nodes and the same encryption as the Mysterium network. It just allows you to pay with traditional payment methods. I'd rather use cryptocurrency though, and it's been a challenge for me to find a way to do that here, at least at this point. And this is something that they're working on. As far as preferences go, you're going to see that all there is a choice in how you're connecting to your DNS, but that's it. It's a pretty simple, useful piece of software that connects and allows you to remain private and encrypted while connected to those nodes. Now, before I give my final review on Mysterium Network, let me explain some of the features that are currently missing that they tell me are in development. First, part of what makes Tor so good is the ability to slice your traffic into different chunks as it gets passed through the internet. This feature is currently being tested in Mysterium, and I'm told it will be released soon, and when it does, it will dramatically increase the level of privacy offered. Along with this, they're also promising relays and multi-hops, which again would add more privacy for users and more protection for risk-intolerant node runners like myself. This basically means that instead of having a single point between you and the internet, your traffic is bounced across a few different nodes before exiting. The difference between this and Tor, in case it wasn't clear, is that Tor is a tool that focuses exclusively on privacy, whereas Mysterium adds a level of access when you need to unblock content or increase your internet speeds. So, what's my final verdict? If you're a privacy nut like I am, you're probably very interested in how this kind of decentralized VPN works, and I recommend you give it a try. In fact, for this period of time when it's free, I think it's a great option for anybody to try. But when I think about somebody like my mom or my good friend who doesn't even understand cryptocurrency, much less how to invest in it, I can see there being a slightly higher barrier to entry for the average person once this goes fully live. But that's the cost of privacy. It's rarely convenient. Let me know what you think about this kind of decentralized VPN in the comments below. And I always appreciate a vote of confidence via that like button. Every little step matters when your goal is to make all things secured.